Hi everyone, welcome to my channel IT Logics. In my channel, I have created a playlist with the name as AWS Event Driven Pipeline for Data Engineer. This pipeline we have created purely on console based. I have not created so far one introductory video for this playlist. So as part of this video, we are going to discuss that what are we going to achieve in this particular project or in this particular workshop. So I have mentioned few points in this Word document. We will discuss them one by one. So first of all, we will see how much will be the overall billing cost in order to implement this playlist. So if you will see in this playlist, I have 7 videos so far, out of which the first video is purely dedicated for architecture diagram discussion. So you can think like from part 2, we have started doing the development till part 7. So doing this exercise in AWS cost me around INR 20 rupees, or in dollar you can say like $0.21. I can show you in AWS console. If you will click in the search bar and you will write billing, you can go over the billing and you can see what all cost it has incurred for you. So you can see over here that for me, as of now, it is $0.21, which is almost around 17 or 18 rupees. And this is true when I have ran my glue job multiple times. Basically, in this workshop, the only service which will cost you is glue job only. So while doing this workshop, I would recommend you to keep your data set as small as possible so that your glue job should get finished in small time interval. In my case, the data set was very small and my glue job used to run within 15 seconds. And because this session was not dedicated to glue and we were not doing any sorts of analytical processing, so that's why I kept my data set very small. And yeah, so it will only take at most 20 rupees for doing this workshop. This is one of the best part of doing this particular project. Now I will just discuss that whatever things we are going to achieve throughout this playlist. So I will discuss about all these videos which I have created so far. So in the part 1, we are just going to discuss about the architecture diagram which we have created for our event-driven pipeline use case. I have already created a diagram which we're going to discuss in detail. So this is the diagram we will be discussing. Going back to the Word document, in part 2, we are going to discuss how to create S3 bucket and SNS topic. So you will see in my diagram, I have 2 S3 buckets over here, one for source files and one for target files. So we are going to create them. Second is we are going to create SNS topic because we are going to create S3 notification, and as part of S3 notification target, we will have SNS topic. So we will learn how to create SNS topic. These are very small topics to cover up. I'll not go in much detail. After that, in the part 2, we will discuss how to create a SQS, because in our architecture diagram, we will be subscribing this SNS and our subscriber will be SQS queue. So we will learn how to create SQS. After that, we will also see how to generate our test messages or how to create text messages in SNS. As soon as we create that test message, that message will go to our SQS because it has subscribed. Okay, after that we will also see that what all necessary permissions this SNS service needed in order to send message to SQS queue. After that, we are going to discuss that once we have a message in SQS, then how can we see the content of that message. We will be using a polling method for that. And if you want to purge the SQS queue, if you want to delete all the messages from SQS queue, then how to do that. In part 3, we are going to discuss how to create our first glue job. And in this video, we are going to create a Python shell job. We are not going to create PySpark job. At the same time, we will also learn how to grab command line argument using getResolvedOptions. This is a very beautiful function provided by glue job, where you can grab the command line argument and use them accordingly into your script. We will also learn how to create an IAM role, and while creating this IAM role, we will provide the necessary permissions. For example, in our case, our glue IAM role would be needing necessary permission to read the file from source path and to load the file into the target path. That will be one. Second is we will also need a permission to store our logs into CloudWatch. So that will be the second permission which we'll be needing. And the third one is obviously the glue related permissions that we will also be needing. So we will also know how to create IAM role, how to attach permissions on it. After that, we will also see that we can also hardcode the command line argument in our glue job, so that while testing our job, we need not to provide those arguments again and again. So that will be also a very good learning. In part four, we are going to learn how to create our first lambda function. And then in that lambda function, we will see that how using Python code we can process the event which are coming from SQS, right? So because in our case, SQS will be trigger for our lambda, we will need to process the messages coming from SQS. So we will process that message and fetch the required information from it. In our tutorial, we have fetched bucket information and file prefix. After that, we will see that how to trigger a glue job from your ETL lambda. We will be using a Boto3 library. We will be creating a glue client, and from lambda, we will be triggering our glue job. That will again be a good learning. Then we will learn how to create a test event in lambda, so that you do not have to wait for creating a SQS trigger. We do not want to create SQS trigger first, and without creating it, we want to test our lambda. In that case, we should have a test event. We will learn how to create it and use it for our testing of our lambda function. Then we also learn how to create S3 notification in our source S3 bucket. And at the same time, we will again see how to provide necessary permission to S3 service, so that it can send message to its target. In our case, the target is SNS. Okay, the same point I have mentioned over here. After that, we will also learn how to create a glue crawler, and also how to create a glue, or you can say Athena database. Then we will see how to create a PagerDuty service. I will give you some high level knowledge on PagerDuty. We will not go too much in detail. And at the same time, we will also learn how to create a Slack workspace, because for this tutorial, we should have one PagerDuty service and Slack workspace. So we are going to discuss that. After that, we will see that once we have a PagerDuty service, then in that PagerDuty service, we can create one CloudWatch integration. And using that integration key, we can subscribe SNS topic. Okay. So that whenever there is any failure of Lambda, using a CloudWatch alarm and dead letter queue concept, we will be generating one PagerDuty incident. That what we're gonna learn. Okay, so we're gonna learn the concept of dead letter queue. If you already know about it, then it's fine. Otherwise, let me just give you a quick summary. In case if Lambda fails to process messages coming from SQS, SQS will move its message from its own queue to dead letter queue. And we will learn the concept of dead letter queue also. Then we will learn the concept of CloudWatch alarm. CloudWatch alarm will help us in order to monitor this dead letter queue. If there are any single messages available, we will generate a PagerDuty incident. Then in the last video, similarly, like we have handled the failure for ETL lambda in order to generate a PagerDuty incident, similarly, we will be handling glue failure, and we will be using event bridge rule for that. So we will learn how to create event bridge rule condition, because in this case, our condition will be glue job run failure. Okay, so we will keep on looking to the state of our glue job. If its state is failed, then its event rule will get triggered, and accordingly, PagerDuty incident will also get triggered. So that was all about it, guys. I hope you will enjoy this playlist. And the only requirement for this is to have your AWS account. If you do not want to continue with PagerDuty and Slack integration, that's fine. But otherwise, if you have AWS account, then it will only cost you around 15 to 20 INR. So that's it. Happy learning, guys.